Thank you, everyone. Again, my name is Thomas T.J. Lofty. Give it up for my brother for the Transformation Tour. It's an amazing thing to be here, you guys. I see y'all looking really good out here, everyone. You know, it's a great time to be a business owner. Give it up for all our vendors back there, these business owners. These are the people that create jobs in our communities. They create hope and opportunities. Let me tell you a little bit about my background. Is that okay? My background is originally, I'm from the low-riding industry. Y'all familiar with those low-riding snow cars? Well, I know y'all like, what the heck you doing up there? What that got to do with this? We at the hair show. Well, I got a lot to do with. So I started manufacturing car parts that I started shipping around the world. So what brings me here today is the manufacturing aspect of the natural hair industry. There is so much opportunity going on than what we ever had before in our lives. And I see a lot of people leaving money on the table. We don't see the vision behind this. Meaning, it's so many things that we never had to go through before. Opportunities that we never had, like Facebook. People are manufacturing their own products and putting them on social media and shipping them around the world. How many of y'all know there's people out here that think that, say for example, $5,000 is a lot of money? Yeah, that's a lot of people. I used to be one of them. Someone told me, they said, TJ, you got people coming from all over Los Angeles and Southern California buying car parts from you. You should advertise. Yeah. I thought to myself, I said, I'm making $5,000 a month. What do I need to advertise for? I thought I had it made, right? Someone convinced me, kept pushing and pushing. He said, advertise in a magazine. So I turned around and invested $500 into an advertisement, and my income quadrupled overnight. How did that happen? I reached out to a magazine that was sold in 4 different countries. 1.2 million users, buyers. So now I got people calling me from all around the world. So I see that happening in this industry right here. We got so much opportunity. What I used to pay thousands of dollars a month for is free now. I see people got social media pages with 5,000 friends on it. Come on, I got 3 pages. We got so much opportunity to become successful and create multi-billion dollar companies just based on what we're doing here alone. So also, before we can take this to the next level, you guys, we got to learn how to do business. Meaning, I see people that's been in business for 20 years in the same salon, and they rent. It's time to start buying, guys. How many of y'all from LA in here?
Hey! LA!
What about Atlanta? Throw some cities out to me. Where y'all from? Everybody from Phoenix?
St. Louis.
Y'all know anything about gentrification? Okay, well, what I'm seeing in gentrification is people coming in, buying these buildings that our beauty salons and beauty and barbershops are in, and they turn around and raising the rent, telling people it's time to go. Well, we don't have to worry about things like that when we own the building. Hey, you can renegotiate your lease. Matter of fact, why don't you team up with your neighbors and purchase the building? Why don't you scale back? We don't always have to go out of business. So I say all I have to say is, real estate is changing. I realized these problems, so I started making DVDs and all type of products to kind of help us through these situations of entrepreneurship. Because it's very critical that we learn this business and what to do with it. We got so much opportunity in front of us. I mean, I'm excited. I'm just excited. We got so many people that are opening businesses up and doing things that can possibly take off and create billions of dollars, but they're just missing certain little bitty pieces of information.
So my question is, what do you do when an up and up economy, and you know the economy just took off and you lease it? The prices. When the prices, everything start going up. What you do is you turn around and you ask the landlord to extend your lease. If the economy start booming and they say, hey, we about to build a Ram Stadium across the street, that means it's time to say, hey, landlord, I would like to either buy this property from you or I would like to extend my lease so I know that the rent won't go up by a whole lot in the next couple of years. So what do you do when you're clearing over $10,000 a month, you guys? Anybody know the answer to that? You go out and buy that new Bentley, you got $10,000 a month from your business coming in. What do you do? We go out and buy a new car, go buy something new to play with. It's time to open a second business. It's time to make another investment in something else. All right. So what do you do when you've been renting over 3 years in the same location. Do we keep renting or what do we do? Time to buy. You should not be in this building for 20 or 30 years. I see people tell me, I'm so proud, I've been here for 20 years. I say, you own it? They say, no, I'm renting. But I'm cool with the landlord. I'm like, you ain't that cool. You done made this man $1 million by now. All right, all right. So anybody in here got a lot of customers moving out of the area? What do you do when you got a business and your customers say, oh, I'm moving out. I'm moving to this area. I'm moving an hour and a half from here. Huh? They expand. That's why when you go in the grocery store, they say, what's your zip code? They want to know where you moving so they can move too. So why don't we start doing the same thing? A lot of those small areas that people are in are very affordable. Okay, that next question. Landlord, what do you do when you're in a building and your landlord say, oh, he's about to sell your property that you're renting or leasing? What do we do? We ask him, how much is he selling it for? We try to buy it. If it's a bunch of different business owners in the same building, we ask him, we all need to come together and buy it from him. Pool our monies together. So what do we do when we got a building for lease or for sale and it's been on the market for 9 months and they say, I want $2,000 a month? Do we walk in and give them $2,000 a month? No. Been on the market that long, that means nobody wants it. You tell them, I'll give you $1,000. Or I'm going to look around the area. I see too many people walk in. Oh, he want $1,000. I got it like that. I'm going to just give it to him. I'm like, dude, they've been on the market for over 9 months. You don't pay full price. So let's talk about a down economy. What do you do in a down economy and business starts to get slow? Do you pack up and move and close down? Yes, I got a yes over here. I got to know, what do we do? When it's a down economy, a lot of people are closing, and that means it's time for you to look for a bigger space. If you got hundreds of vacancies around you, you look around, there's a whole lot of vacant buildings around you, these landlords can't rent the place. So I see people go from $1,000 a month for a 4,000 square foot property to $1,000 a month for a 6,000 square foot property. Why? Because they can't rent these places out. So we don't close down, we move, we find a better location that's affordable in our budget. We should never close. Always look for a more affordable location or ask your landlord, will he renegotiate your lease? Do you think he want his place vacant too? No. All right, here go another. What's the difference between buying a building or building your own building? Anybody know? I'm about to give you a DVD. That's a young person. Raise their hand. The difference is when people go to buy a piece of property, you got like multiple offers on most properties. Y'all familiar with that term? Meaning it's 10 people trying to buy the same property that makes the property go through the roof and there is no equity. But if you go and build a property, you probably can build it for a quarter of the cost. And what happens when you build something for a quarter of the cost? You have equity. Big difference. All right, you guys. These are simple problems that most people go out of business over.